Now, I know some of you are extremely excited about this new development of Alibaba Group. Alibaba is an e-commerce company, it's a financial services company, it's a cloud computing company. Now, they're even into chip manufacturing. Hey, slow down. I'd just like to bring you back to reality. We have to have a very strong distinction between chip design and chip manufacturing. Right now, the e-commerce giant is not into chip manufacturing, but instead into chip design. So Alibaba is said to be launching a new server chip based on ARM technology this week. So by the time I upload this video, it's probably already out. So the e-commerce giant, which runs its own semiconductor design unit called Pingtouge, is reportedly unveiling a new chip soon. So the Chinese companies have been rushing into chip design, which requires less investment than chip manufacturing. So like I said, there's distinction between chip designing and chip manufacturing. Do you understand the amount of capacity, the expertise, and the amount of investment needed to go through all the entire setting up into the chip manufacturing infrastructure? And right now, for companies being able to have the expertise and capabilities to manufacture the 5-nanometer processor, only comes down to two companies, which is Samsung Electronics and Taiwan Semiconductor. Alibaba just unveiled one of China's most advanced chip. So let's see how advanced it is. So essentially, Alibaba Group unveiled a new server chip that's based on the advanced 5-nanometer technology, marking a milestone in China's pursuit of semiconductor self-sufficiency. I think this entire idea of self-sufficiency needs to be emphasized even more. So as you all know, during the heightened phase of the US-China tension, during the Trump administration, they banned one of China's leading tech giants, which is Huawei Technology, and they cite national security reasons, like always. But anyway, I think one of the core pillars and core strategy of the current government in China is to really ensure that regardless of what are the developments with all the entire external environment, whether hostile or not, they will have the ability to ride through all the storms, which is also why there's this focus on being self-reliant and self-sufficient. Now, in the Department of Chip Design, the US counterpart actually do have a monopoly in terms of innovation and in terms of efficiency. And as you all know, if you were to just study the different companies that are trying to be more self-sufficient right now, the classic and prime example is Apple. Apple used to rely on Intel in terms of the chip manufacturing capabilities. And as you all know, recently they just transited over to their own M1 silicon chip. And with this transition, according to any forms of benchmark, Apple essentially just blew them all out of the water. Regardless of whether they are using Intel's chips or even AMD graphics card, they just blow all the competition out of the water. So with the ability to design your own chip, it comes with the flexibility of manufacturing your own chip and ensuring that it suits your own needs, even in idiosyncratic ways. And Apple has managed to unlock the huge amount of value, which is also why you can see more and more tech companies are trying to harness their own chip design capabilities. Now, the Chinese tech giant's newest chip is based on a microarchitecture provided by the SoftBank Group Corporation owned ARM Limited. So for those of you who do not know, SoftBank is also the largest institutional investor of Alibaba Group. So having the ability to marry both companies under the portfolio of the same investment holding company is definitely a good thing, because if both company flourishes, SoftBank is the ultimate winner. But there's a very big problem with ARM Limited, which I'll be discussing in the later part of the video, so please remember to stay on. And I think that's the biggest challenge China will be faced with in the medium term. So remember to smash the like button and continue watching on. Now, Alibaba said that the silicon will be put to use in its own data centers in the near future and will not be sold commercially, at least for now. So ultimately right now, I think the focus of Alibaba Group is to really harness their capabilities and make sure that it's competent enough to go out and blow their competitions out of the water as well. And they're really not looking towards in trying to monetize their capabilities, but instead being able to value add to their entire ecosystem, make it more efficient, make it better, and make it more capable. Customizing our own server chip is consistent with our ongoing efforts towards boosting our computing capabilities with better performance and improved energy efficiency. We plan to use the chips to support current and future businesses across the Alibaba Group ecosystem. So Alibaba server chip is one of the most advanced by a Chinese firm yet, as it joins global rivals like Amazon and Google in gradually replacing silicon from traditional chip makers like Intel and AMD with products custom designed for their data centers and workload. So Xi Jinping's government has made tech self-sufficiency a top national priority, setting aside billions in government funding and offering a wide range of policy support to help local firms overcome US sanctions on the industry. So this is one of the most critical facts and one of the most pertinent points of this entire video. And of course, by just reading the headlines of, hey, Alibaba is venturing into chip making, you're not able to connect the dots, which is why I'm here to provide you with my own opinion. But I'll complete this article first. With limited domestic semiconductor manufacturing capabilities, Alibaba will likely still have to outsource production. So TSMC, which is Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing, and South Korea's Samsung Electronics are the two companies capable of mass producing the 5nm chips. Essentially, I'm not here to start a war on whether Taiwan belongs to China or not. It's not in my capacity to comment. Let both of them sort out their own internal affairs and internal politics. But anyway, I'll just like to focus on the idea that, hey, Alibaba, like any of its competitors and any of TSMC or Samsung's customers, they will probably have to obey conventional business practices and to work with them like normal suppliers. Now, to backdate to one of the articles that was released in May, Alibaba is making its cloud OS compatible with multiple chip architecture. So Alibaba's cloud computing unit is making its OS compatible with processing based on ARM, x86, RISC, and among other architectures. Essentially, they're just trying to make it more holistic, more encompassing, and just more flexible in any case. So this entire paragraph highlighted in green is the most pertinent fact. ARM was forced to decide its relationship with Huawei and said it could continue licensing to the Chinese firm as it's of UK origin. But Huawei still struggles to find fabs that are both capable and are allowed to actually manufacture the chips designed using the architecture. So what's the growing concern here? Because ARM is not originated in the US. Essentially, when the US-China tension picks up speed again, who knows what will happen? Because ultimately speaking, we know that the UK is one of the strongest ally of the US as well. So if they really want to starve China, this is just an additional negotiation chip on the table. So now, what all of you have been waiting for? What is the relationship and how do we connect the dots? So to go back in time, SoftBank Group actually made the acquisition in ARM in September 2016. But the biggest issue now is the American tech company Nvidia actually announced plan in 2020 to acquire ARM from SoftBank. However, the acquisition, which is initially scheduled to conclude before the end of 2022, is likely to be extended beyond the initial plan period due to the extended talks with the regulators. So essentially, the regulators are just trying to ascertain whether there's a monopoly and whether it's being fair to the competition and whatnot. But I think one of the most important concerns that I have as a shareholder is really the monopoly the US have in terms of the chip designing industry. Of course, out of the multitude of issues, because the entire US and China economy is so deeply entrenched and it's so intricate, China on their end also have quite a few negotiation chips. But essentially, the US is now trying to strengthen their bargaining power and their negotiation capabilities by stacking the odds into their favor. So ultimately, the conclusion is that this is a race against time. Will all these big tech companies, under the encouragement of the Chinese government, be able to outpace and outwork all these different acquisitions, all these different monopolies that the US is trying to establish? Or would it just be an additional weapon being included into the arsenal of the US negotiation table? Us as shareholders should really keep our eyes peeled in this entire chip making industry, because I would believe that there will be a profound impact in terms of how this industry will be on the negotiation table in the near future. So before I end off this video, I would just like to end off with a quote by one of the analyst reports from the big banks out there. And you can tell that the Xi administration is extremely serious about it, and the entire strategy is to make sure that they are self-sufficient, self-reliant, and to make sure that their foreign partners do not have them by the neck. At a sector level, we favor industries that are less subject to regulatory scrutiny and are aligned with the national development objective, notably foundational hard technology like semiconductors and B2B software, hard and renewable energy like solar, wind and gas, and new infrastructure like electric vehicle and 5G network, which collectively define our alpha generating universe until the market reaches a new regulatory equilibrium. So I think this provides you with a very brief context. And more importantly, it also helps you glimpse some valuable insights in how Alibaba's management team is positioning the company to help CCP achieve their national development objective. With that in mind, I'll see you in the next video, but more importantly, I'll see you on the moon. Goodbye!